So the next speaker is. Sorry.
Okay, next one.
You can introduce the next speaker.
Okay, so next speaker will be the smoking cessation and meta-analysis. The first evidence level is a review from low and middle income countries by Dr. Eric Wong, Chang Hong, and the colleagues from Lok Institute of Medical Research.
Good afternoon, everyone. Thank you for coming to the session. My name is Eric. And for the next 10 minutes, I'm going to share with you a systematic review that I have been working on with my colleagues. So the message today that I want you to remember and to keep in mind, think a bit about after going out of the door, is the two words, implementation and research. Please keep this in mind, and we'll come back to this later. Now imagine this, that you are a lung doctor reading a research article like this one. It's a randomized control trial about smoking cessation coming from United States. And what are the implications of this study for you? A healthcare worker in Vietnam or a country nearby? You probably think nothing. There's no implication for you. And are you going to use the results of the study to change your clinical practice? And it's probably no, because the United States is the United States. I work in Vietnam, and I has nothing to do with this research. So this is exactly the reason why we are going to do this research. Tobacco smoking, as you know, is the leading cause of mortality and morbidity all around the world, and the rate of spontaneous cessation is very low, not just in Vietnam, but everywhere in the world. And despite the smoke-free hospital policy and all other policies about smoking cessation, your colleagues and your patients continue to smoke. Then you might wonder, is there any evidence that I can use to address the situation? But then you will find out that most of the studies were conducted in high-income countries. Then you will ask yourself a question, what about low and middle income countries? Do we have evidence? Do we have strong evidence to support the smoking cessation intervention in my own country? So here comes the research question. What is the effectiveness of smoking cessation intervention implemented within healthcare settings in low and middle income countries? The study was conducted in accordance with the PRISMA guidelines, research department, MENAI, MBES, Cochrane, Library, Lydica's clinical trials and great literature, looking for studies that make comparisons, which is randomized control trial, quasi-experimental studies, before and after study. And we include studies published from January 1990 to September 2017. Two independent reviewers screened and extracted the data separately before making comparison. And if there was a discordance, the opinion of a third reviewer will be considered before making the final judgment. Now here is the search strategy. We included terms for healthcare workers who implement the research, the intervention, and then terms for patients who receive the intervention and healthcare facility where the intervention took place. And then the terms for smoking cessation interventions. So after searching for the articles in those databases, we identified almost 9,000 articles. So you can imagine that the screening process is quite long. And after excluded some articles, for example, we exclude studies from high-income countries, studies with no control group, and studies with no cessation outcomes, and studies with that is not published in English journal. We ended up with 29 articles in our review, and were able to meta-analyze 15 of them. Now this slide shows you the geography of the studies that we included. 31% of the study were conducted in Western Pacific region, followed by 23% in the Americas, and then 15% in Southeast Asia and Eastern Mediterranean, and then 8% in European region and African region. Now you may notice that almost half of the studies were conducted in countries around Vietnam. For example, China, Malaysia, and Indonesia. In terms of the types of intervention, out of the 29 articles, 20 studies involved counseling, and 15 of them included pharmacotherapy, including nicotine replacement therapy and bupropion, varenicline, and nortriptyline. And phone call and behavior group were used in 5 and 2 articles, respectively. Now let's look at the meta-analysis. Four research compare brief counseling versus with usual care. Now from the risk ratio 1.64, we can see that it means patients receiving brief counseling is 64% more likely to quit smoking. And then there are some articles provide follow-up counseling instead of just giving baseline counseling. So from the risk ratio 2.28, you can see that patient receiving counseling and also follow-up counseling is 2 times more likely to quit smoking compared to baseline counseling when the patient came to the hospital for just once. And then there are some studies talk about pharmacotherapy. And we are more interested in the studies follow up patient more than 6 months because there are some studies follow patient only for like 3 months or 4 months. So you can see from the risk ratio of the studies following patient more than 6 months, the risk ratio is 1.33. So that patients receiving both counseling and pharmacotherapy is 33% more likely to quit smoking at the end. So this is the discussion. This review shows positive results for smoking cessation implemented in low and middle income countries like Vietnam. And counseling is very useful, even a brief one. So talk to your patients for 5 minutes or 10 minutes. Is it going to help them? Then follow up and medicines are going to help. But we should notice that heterogeneity of the review is quite high, both in study design and also in sample sizes. And one thing to notice is that further health economic analysis is necessary so that we can identify cost-effective measures that can be implemented and can be scaled up. And also affordability for the patient is very important. Now back to the message that I want you to know. The first is implementation. How do you implement a smoking cessation program in your country, in your healthcare system is very important. How do you monitor and how to evaluate the program? We need a pragmatic approach that is suitable for your local context and your local system. And the second is research. Research from Vietnam is very important. We do need research from Vietnam. It's like the tuberculosis program in Vietnam. Many people are learning from you. It's not necessary that we learn everything from high-income countries. If you have any good idea to treat patients with, to help a patient quit smoking, try to find evidence, to produce evidence, and then publish in English journal so that more people can learn from you. People around the world, experts around the world can learn from you. So this is my presentation. Thank you very much.